All right, this next step is probably my favorite thing about fall makeup, especially for every day, and that is the lipstick. Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. So today, I thought it would be fun to share with you my favorite everyday makeup for fall. Now, this isn't gonna be too product specific. There are definitely some certain products that I always get really excited to reach for on almost a daily basis when fall rolls around. But for the most part, it's more of just like a vibe. When it comes to fall makeup, I feel like for some reason when sweater weather comes around, I feel like it's more appropriate to wear more makeup. It's not as hot outside, so you don't have to really worry about your makeup slipping and sliding off as much as you do in the summer months. So my routine does change a little bit, and so I thought it would be kind of fun to share with you guys the overall vibe that I personally love to go for when it comes to fall makeup. And this can definitely be like an everyday situation, or it might be some of your special occasion makeup, but for me, I do go a little bit more bold with my everyday makeup in fall. So let's just get right into it. I'm actually gonna do the complexion first. That's usually what I do when it comes to an everyday routine. Honestly, when it comes to fall and when the weather cools down a little bit, I'm not usually too picky about like a primer. I usually just want very hydrated skin, and I feel like I can get away with even more hydration than I do in the summertime just because, again, it's not too hot and I'm not sweating as much. So for today, I'm just gonna use like a good replenishing face primer. This is the Hangover X Replenishing Face Primer from Too Faced, and it's just basically like a moisturizer. I technically probably could have gone straight into makeup after my skincare today, but I just wanted to make sure to tell you that this is usually the kind of product that I reach for, especially when the weather gets cooler. My skin always tends to get pretty dry, so extra hydration always helps. For foundation, I wanted to use something that's just been foolproof. This is definitely something that has been in my everyday routine during the summer as well, but I think it's gonna be great for the fall. It's the Ulma Beauty Say What Foundation. This is just such a good, solid in-between foundation, and I say in-between because it's not too dewy, it's not too matte. It lasts so well on my skin in the summertime, so it's gonna last even better in the fall and even winter. I love it so much. I'm just gonna take one pump on the back of my hand, and I'm going to use a brush. This one is from Real Techniques, and I'm just gonna start kind of on the center of the face. I like to focus my coverage on like my cheek area because that's where I have the most discoloration. And then once there's less on the brush, that's when I'll bring it toward the center of the face and kind of even out the skin tone on the nose. And then I'll take the rest and kind of just blend things out on the forehead. I like this foundation too because you can get really, really nice coverage, but it's not too heavy. Like, you don't have to use a ton of product to get the coverage that you want, especially on an everyday basis. I don't want my skin to feel or look heavy, but I do love a good even coverage all over the skin. And this foundation definitely delivers that exact thing for me. So once I have everything pretty blended out, I'm gonna take what's left on the back of my hand, which is not really that much, and I'm just gonna take my sponge and make sure that everything is pressed into the skin so that everything looks nice and even. And if you guys are watching this video wanting to like follow along or recreate this look, keep in mind that, again, it doesn't necessarily matter which product you're using. You can use whatever your current favorite foundation is, like whatever you've been loving for summer. Take that into fall, you know? You can just use what you have to recreate the same exact vibe that I'm gonna show you today with the things that you already know and love, you know? All right, we're gonna move into concealer. I do really love a little bit more of like a flawless T-zone, something that has a little bit more of like a matte texture when it comes to fall makeup. But again, it's important to make sure that your skin's not too dry when you're using products like this. So that's also why I wanted to make sure that I hydrated my skin with my skincare. And then also I used the hydrating primer. I'm gonna be wearing the NARS Soft Matte Complete Concealer. This is a product that I have really, really been enjoying recently, even in the summer as well, but it's just so good for that smooth looking under eye area and T-zone. I'm just gonna take that on an eyeshadow brush actually and just start buffing this out underneath the eyes. I'm gonna bring a little bit of that into the T-zone just slightly, just to brighten and smooth things out there, and a little bit on the chin. And we'll go on the sides of the nose too, just to cancel out that redness. I feel like buffing this in with a fluffy brush really, really works well for the initial application. And then, as always, I go back in with my sponge just to make sure that there's no harsh brush lines and that everything is nice and pressed into the skin. Another really great option that will give you a similar effect, I'm not sure if they're like exact dupes for each other or anything, but the Maybelline Instant Age Rewind Concealer does a really good job at smoothing out the under eye area, and it has a little bit more of that whipped matte finish, which again is what I typically reach for when doing a fall makeup look. I'm just gonna gently take what's left on that concealer brush, the concealer brush, and I'm just gonna kind of buff that over top of blemishes that need a little extra coverage. I don't have too many today, which is nice. Another thing that I always look forward to for fall makeup is a more sculpted complexion. I feel like you can get away with a little bit more contour and things. Obviously, there's no rules when it comes to makeup and like when you can wear them, but for me personally, I don't usually do too much of a contoured situation in the spring or summer for every day. If I'm going out, then maybe I'll do a little bit more definition, but for every day, I really don't. So that's why I'm excited to use this. Okay, so I'm gonna be using the Oma Beauty Double Take Sculpt and Strobe Stick, and I'm gonna use the shade White Pearl. I'm gonna use the contour stick in this, and I'm literally just going to sculpt the cheeks. I'm gonna do a little bit right here on the temples, just a bit on the forehead. Now, this has a little bit more of a cool tone to it, so for my skin tone, it's not gonna really warm up the complexion as much as it is going to add that definition. So I actually have another bronzer that I will use later to bring in that warmth. So I'm just gonna kind of run this along the jawline as well. And then I'm actually gonna take the brush that we used with the foundation, and I'm going to smooth out this contour. I feel like when I use the same brush that I used the foundation on to blend out my contour, for every day, especially when I'm kind of trying to move a little bit more quickly, it really helps everything just blend into the complexion without looking too harsh, because you have that leftover foundation to kind of help blend it into the existing colors on the face. I'm gonna make sure to blend that down the neck a little bit as well, not too far because I'm wearing a turtleneck, but far enough to where everything kind of blends together. And then I'm just gonna go back over everything, mainly on the edges of that contour with my sponge, again, just to make sure that everything is super blended. All right, so I'm actually gonna set the T-zone really quickly and set the brow area. I'm gonna be using the Ciate London Everyday Vacay Coconut Setting Powder. Any powder that's gonna be like a little bit more lightweight and smoothing on the skin will do the trick. I really like this powder. This is a little bit of a newer powder to my collection, but I've been using it a lot, especially for every day, because again, I feel like it's not too heavy, but it sets and blurs the skin really nicely. So I'm just gonna take this and start pressing it underneath the eye area. And you'll notice that I left my eyelids bare. That's because I have a cream shadow that I'm gonna use. And normally when I use a cream shadow, I don't go in with like concealer on the eyelid to cancel things out. I feel like that ends up being too much product for my personal eyelids. Like, because I have more hooded eyelids, it tends to crease if I put too much product on. So I left my eyelids alone, but I'll show you in just a second how I use that cream eyeshadow to cancel out the discoloration. So again, for me, I always get oily in the T-zone throughout the day, so no matter what time of year it is, I'm always at least setting the T-zone, if not the whole face. For right now, I'm just setting the T-zone, and I'm running a little powder through the brows. I find that this really helps when I apply my brow pencil. It just helps things kind of stick a little bit better. Whoa, that powder went everywhere. All right, so I'm just gonna go in with my Benefit Precisely, my brow pencil in the shade 4. This is just one of my most reliable brow pencils, so when it comes to everyday makeup, I tend to reach for the same old things. Okay, now that my brows are on, we're gonna move on to the eyes. And again, this is where I'm gonna use the liquid eyeshadow. I've talked about this a few times on my channel recently, especially. I'm just so in love with them. It's the Too Faced Melted Chocolate Matte Eyeshadows. I adore these. So there's a couple of ways you can do this. You can apply it to the back of your hand and use a brush and just go in like that. You can dot it on your eye and blend it out. The thing is with this formula specifically is you do wanna make sure to work with one eye at a time. They dry down pretty quickly, and you're gonna wanna make sure to apply most of the product where you want the most definition. So for me, I always start like closer to the lash line and then I sweep up and out once I have a little less product on the brush. So since this is a deeper shade, I am going to actually apply it to my hand first. And this color is called Warm and Fudgy, and I just feel like it's so perfect for fall. So I'm taking that on my brush and I'm just gonna start, I need a mirror for this. I'm just gonna start kind of buffing this out on the eyelid, again, keeping most of the pigment close to the lashes. And then once there's a little less on the brush, that's when you can kind of start blending it up and out. And this is a darker shade, so usually what I like to do as well is I'll take a clean brush, and before it dries, I'll just kind of buff the actual edges out to kind of create a little bit of that transition color. And you can wear these alone, or you can use them as an eyeshadow base. I'm actually gonna use it as an eyeshadow base today. I'm just taking a little bit more on that first brush we were using, and I'm just taking that right along the lower lash line. Also, another trick, if you feel like you came in a little bit too close, I feel like I kind of brought that in too far, I'm taking what's left on the concealer brush and just buffing that out. And it makes it really easy to just kind of create more of a faded kind of shadow look. So the shadow that I had already applied to my hand to just do that one eye is already dried and set. So that's why it's important to do one eye at a time when you're doing this. I'm just going to do the same exact thing for the other eye. A little bit goes a very long way with this product. So I'm going to go back in with that same brush and literally just do the exact same thing that I just showed you. So the nice thing about these eyeshadows is they literally do not smudge or budge. Like, I'm really having to try to remove it off the back of my hand with a wipe, and it's taking some time, and even then, there's still a little bit left over. So it's really gonna adhere to the eyes well, which is also why I like to use it as an eyeshadow base. You can use it by itself. You could just apply mascara and keep going. But for today's look, I really wanted to use it more as a base. So I'm gonna go in with the Persona Cosmetics Identity Palette. I love reaching for like muted, almost more cool toned. Well, I kind of use warm and cool tones in the fall, but just these like classic neutral colors. And this palette has been one of my favorites for such a long time, but they just actually redid their packaging. So it's the same shades and same formula as the original Identity palette, but in new packaging. So they just recently sent this to me. I wanted to try out the palette in the new packaging. So let's just get right into this. So I'm actually wanting to take this warmer tone called Audacious. It's a really nice matte. And I'm just gonna start to layer this on the outer portion of that outer lid. I mean upper lid. The outer portion of the upper lid is what I'm trying to say. And we're just gonna add a little bit more warmth to that initial eye base. Also gonna add some of that to the outer third of the lower lash line, right on top of that eye base as well. And then I'm just taking a clean brush again and kind of making sure that those edges are nice and blended. All right, next I'm actually gonna take the shade Bombshell. Any of these shimmer shades would work for this look, but I just kind of want a cool taupey kind of a color. This almost has like a greenish undertone to it, which is really, really unique. So that's why I wanted to layer it on top, almost to kind of neutralize the eye look, but also I think it looks really, really interesting paired with like the warmer tone that I just applied on the outer corner. Going back in with the brush we were just using with the warm outer corner shade, and I didn't add any more product, but I always like to just kind of blend out the edges after applying a shimmer shade to the lid. I'm gonna take that same Bombshell shade and I'm going to run that across the inner portion of the lower lash line, and I'm stopping that about halfway across the lower lash line. Again, I'm taking that brush we were just using. I didn't add any extra product, and I'm just making sure the edges on that lower lash line are nice and blended. I'm gonna go back in with, I don't know what brush was the clean brush I was using, so I'm gonna take another clean brush just to make sure these edges are nice and soft. I'm taking what's left on my powder brush and just kind of cleaning up the edges right here. I felt like they were a little splotchy, so taking what's left on my powder brush really helps to just diffuse that. All right, so another thing that I really love when it comes to fall makeup is good old beefy lashes. I love a good voluminous lash. So normally I would reach for something like the L'Oreal Lash Paradise mascara. I love the Hourglass Caution mascara. But for today, I think I'm gonna use one of these. I can't decide. I've been like really into the Maybelline Lash Sensational. It doesn't smudge or flake on me, which is really great, but I get a little bit more volume with this L'Oreal Voluminous. You know what? I think I just barely used this one in a video, so I'm gonna use just the classic L'Oreal Voluminous Original Mascara. And I'm gonna layer this on the top and bottom lashes, and I'm gonna really, really layer it up. Like, I like really voluminous lashes, especially when I have any sort of eyeshadow on. And I'm gonna be really generous on the lower lashes as well. All right, so next, this part is technically like optional, especially if the cream bronzer that you used had like a little more warmth to it. But for me, I like to layer bronzer to create that warmth on top of like the sculpted, cool toned cream contour that we just applied. So I'm going to go ahead and use my Milani Silky Matte Bronzer. This is one of my very, very favorites. And I'm just gonna make sure to warm up the complexion a little bit more. Again, I'm making sure to kind of bronze up behind the ears a little bit since my hair is back, and to blend that down the neck a little bit so that it all looks seamless. All right, so for highlighter, I wanted to use something that had a little more glow. Again, I feel like you can get away with more obvious highlight in the fall months. At least that's how I feel. I'm gonna use this right here from Revlon. It's the Revlon Skin Lights Prismatic Highlighter in the shade Daybreak Glimmer. And I'm just gonna start dusting that on the high points of the cheeks. It's been a while since I've used this highlighter and it's so pretty. Just going down the center of the face as well. And I always like to just take the highlighter that I'm using and use that as my inner corner highlight. I think it just helps tie the entire look together. So I'm just gonna go ahead and pop that in the inner corner. And I'm gonna take what's left and go right underneath the highest point of the brow. For blush, I usually reach for something that's gonna be a little bit more muted, but I really do love blush still. So for me, I like to find that in between, and I feel like this one does the trick for me. It's the Revlon Just Powder Blush in the shade Naughty Nude. This one has a little bit of a sheen to it, but it's just a nice, almost basic, but in a good way. It's like a basic blush color that still adds color to the cheeks while not looking too like spring or summery, you know? I'm just gonna take my sponge and go around the edges of the blush. And then I also like to kind of press that over the highlighter too. I'm gonna wipe off any foundation that got on the lips. All right, this next step is probably my favorite thing about fall makeup, especially for every day, and that is the lipstick. I feel like, just like everything else, you can get away with a more bold lip or a little bit more on the lips in the fall. That's just how I feel anyway. And I specifically get excited to wear the KKW Beauty 90s collection. She had like this matte lipstick collection that was very 90s inspired, and I always get really excited to wear them in the fall. So I think I want to wear the shade 90s Glam. It's really cool because there's a lip liner and then a corresponding lipstick that's the same name, but they're not the same color, so it makes it really easy to pair them together. I'm just gonna go ahead and line and fill in the lips with this. It's kind of hard to do while I'm talking. And you could go even more bold than this with this look, in my opinion. But I wanted to show you how this one looked because this color is kind of like a bold everyday kind of a color. I don't know why my lip lines got all weird. I might have to perfect those in just a second. But here is the corresponding lipstick. Again, this is the matte lipstick in the shade 90s Glam. And it's lighter than the lip liner, which is kind of the point. It gives you that really fun, iconic looking 90s lip with the darker lip liner and a lighter lipstick. Again, this is another one of those things that you can create with whatever you have at home. And I always like to just press this formula into the lips, and then I'll take my finger and press that in further. I'm going back in with my lip liner just to make sure you can still see that deeper definition. Okay, I'm just gonna step back and assess the situation. I'm adding more bronzer just with what's left on the brush. And then I feel like everything else looks pretty good. Like, I like where the blush is at and the highlighter too. So I'm gonna go ahead and just set the face with a hydrating spray. This is the Too Faced Hangover 3-in-1 Replenishing Primer and Setting Spray. I'm just gonna mist this all over the face. I've got my handy fan. All right, after I have dried the setting spray, I like to take my sponge and just press everything into the skin one more time. This is also where I will take a little bit more powder. I'm just gonna actually use the same coconut powder from Ciate that I was using earlier and just make sure that the T-zone is nice and locked down. And then, as always, I can't leave the house without brow gel, so I'm gonna take my Benefit 24-Hour Brow Setter and just run that through the brows to set. All right, you guys, so that completes this everyday fall look. I know that some of you might be thinking, oh my gosh, that's way too glam for me for every day, and that's fine. That's the beauty of makeup. It's like whatever you want your everyday makeup to be, do what makes you feel beautiful and do what makes you feel good. But for me, I do feel like I can get away with this much makeup on an everyday basis if I have the time or if I'm feeling inspired to. Obviously, you could definitely, you know, create shortcuts when it comes to a look like this. Like I said, you could just use one shadow all over the eyes, like a cream one or a powder one, and just pop on mascara and do the lips. You could skip a darker lip and spend time on the eyeshadow. I mean, whatever works for you. But for me, I genuinely love this type of makeup. This is really, really fun to finally be doing some fall makeup looks. This is my first official fall look that I'm doing on my channel this year, so I'm really excited. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I hope you enjoyed the final look as much as I do. If you're new here, hi, my name is Allie, and I would love for you to join the family. You can do so by hitting the subscribe button, and if you're already a subscriber but you want to be notified on Tuesdays, Thursdays, and Saturdays at 10 a.m. Pacific Standard Time, click on the bell after you subscribe, and you'll get a notification every single time I post. I want to know in the comments what your go-to fall products are, so be sure to tell me in the comments down below. I hope you guys have an amazing day wherever you are, and I will see you in my next video. Love you. Bye!